In this video, I'm going to show you some nutritious meals you can make in 3 minutes that will help you lose fat and gain muscle. Now, obviously, good nutrition alone is not going to build muscle. To build muscle, you need a good resistance training program like the ones on my website. Similarly, you can't lose body fat with good nutrition alone. You need to add the daily cardio. These meals are high in protein, low in fat, and high in fiber so that you can get filled up with fewer calories. Just a reminder, this video is second of a two-part series, and you'll get a lot more out of this video if you watch the other one first. It's titled Six-Pack Abs Fast, and you can watch it by clicking right here. Most articles on nutrition give you a lot of fancy, delicious recipes you can make, but who's got time to shop and chop and cook? And I certainly don't have the ability. Ah, the smoke alarm. Dinner's ready. Oh, you know, chicken breast, broccoli, and brown rice is a nutritious meal, but for people like me who use a smoke detector to know when dinner's done, it's just too complicated. Let me show you some easier meals. There's only three things you need to make my recipes. First and most importantly, a can opener. Second, microwave. Third, and optionally, a blender. Now, I'm a kitchen clod, but even I can handle these things. Proper nutrition is the key to losing fat and gaining muscle at the same time. Now, just to recap the nutritional guidelines in my last video, first and most important, we're going to eat 5 to 6 small, well-balanced meals a day. Second, and very important, we're going to eat a lot of vegetables. Vegetables have a lot of fiber, so they fill you up without many calories. Next, we're going to try to eat less than 10% of our calories from fat. Next, our carbs are going to be whole grains, again, because they have fiber and the fiber fills you up with fewer calories. Now, these last two things are most important if you're trying to add muscle at the same time. So let's emphasize these. Each meal needs to have 15 to 25 grams protein so that your muscles have a constant supply of protein to rebuild. And most important, we're going to try to lose the fat gradually, no more than 1 pound a week. If you lose the fat too quickly, you run the risk of burning off muscle as well as fat. And if you lose the fat gradually, around 1 pound a week, you're not going to have that problem. You'll be able to lose the fat and gain the muscle at the same time. Okay, let's talk about portion size. Now, I really hate to do this because most of you focus way too much on calories and not enough on eating healthy. If you stick to the healthy meals that I show in this video and eat your 5 to 6 meals a day, then you're going to lose weight naturally without having to count calories. Having said that, I know there's a lot of you out there who really like pretty numbers. So here they are. On the left side is your current weight, and on the right side of the chart is the number of calories you need to consume per meal to lose 1 pound a week. So as an example, if you weigh 180 pounds and want to lose 1 pound a week, you need to consume 360 calories in each of your 6 meals for a total of 2,200 calories to lose that pound a week. Now, something really interesting you'll notice here, a person who is 280 pounds can eat a lot more calories than someone weighs 140 pounds and still lose 1 pound a week. What that means is that if you have a lot of weight to lose, you might start out with 510 calories per meal, and as you lose weight, you're going to have to continually reduce your portion size if you want to
continue to lose a pound a week. So one thing in this video, I'm assuming a 180 pound person, so my portion sizes are 360 calories. Now obviously you're going to need to adjust this based on your current weight. And what you need to do is just choose a starting portion size and try it out for a month and see what your weight loss is, and then adjust your calories up or down to get the desired 1 pound a week of fat loss.
Okay, let's get started cooking. Now, breakfast is the most important meal of the day. I know you've heard this 100 times before. I'm going to say it again. Breakfast is the most important meal of the day. You've gone 8 to 10 hours without any food, and your muscles need a quick infusion of protein.
But I am not hungry in the morning.
Ask me if I care. You need to eat breakfast.
I'm going to give you two excellent options for the first meal of the day. One cold and one hot. Okay, let's go with a hot one. The best thing, oats. Not the kind that come in the sugary little packets, just good old-fashioned oats. And because I'm not a measuring kind of guy, I just put in a little water. And there it goes. Took me, what, 10 seconds? And done. Yummy oatmeal. Now, the cold option is going to be a whole wheat product, one of these shredded wheat type products, two biscuits, and the only ingredient in these is whole wheat. There's no sugar, there's no salt, nothing else. You can substitute a different cold cereal, but there can be no sweeteners in it whatsoever. So check the ingredients. There's very few things that will meet this requirement other than these wheat-type biscuit products. Now, in both cases, we're going to use milk for protein, and non-fat milk only. Not low-fat, not whole milk, non-fat. And we're going to use a cup and a half of milk in each case to get our minimum 15 grams of protein. And in this case, we'll pour it over our biscuits. Or in the case of the oatmeal, we'll just drink it out of a cup. Now, it's really important that if you drink milk, it's non-fat milk.
But I don't like non-fat milk. It tastes like chalk water.
Tough. You're going to have to make some sacrifices here. The problem is, even low-fat milk has an incredible amount of fat, and that gives you a lot of calories that you don't need if you're trying to lose weight. So non-fat, zero, goose egg. And people also ask, can I substitute yogurt? Well, maybe. The problem is most yogurts are full of sugar and fat. So if you want to substitute yogurt, you may, as long as there's no sugar and no fat.
Okay, let's look at the nutritional information for your two choices of the first meal of the day. The first, the oatmeal, and then the two biscuits. Now remember, depending on your weight, you may need to have your portion size larger or smaller than this. By the way, just for purposes of comparison, here's the nutritional information for the chicken, broccoli, and brown rice meal that I so carefully charred to bits at the beginning of this video.
Our first meal is going to be a salmon burrito with frozen mixed vegetables. Now, as I said in part one, vegetables are your best friend when you're losing weight. They have lots of fiber and they fill you up without any calories at all. So we're going to get those started. 2/3 of a cup of vegetables. What can go on your frozen vegetables? Three things and only three things. First, if your doctor says it's okay, plain old salt is a good flavoring. Second, balsamic vinegar. There's no sugar and there's no fat. Great flavoring. Third, even better, is salsa. Again, it's just more vegetables. There's no sugar and no fat. What you can't put on, no salad dressing. I know there's light and non-fat salad dressings out there, but they're either loaded with sugar or fat. So no salad dressing. No goopy nothings. While the vegetables are finishing up, let's work on our burrito. We're going to take some non-fat refried beans, not low.
I love beans.
You gnomes are so juvenile. But thank you for bringing up an excellent point. All these meals are really high in fiber. And if your system's not used to it, you better ease into it over a few weeks or you're going to suffer from gastrointestinal distress. We don't like that. No fat, non-fat. Time to get this can opener working. Okay, and then salmon. We're going to use skinless, boneless salmon. Great source of essential fatty acids. And we're only going to use an ounce of this salmon because there's plenty of protein in the beans as well. Okay, the last item, tortillas. These are whole grain, high fiber, low fat tortillas. Okay, now to make the burrito, take our tortilla. Half a cup of refried beans, an ounce of salmon, bloop, and I like a little salsa on mine. And there we go, all done. Okay, the vegetables take less than 2 minutes to cook. And then I'll pop the burrito in for 30 seconds. And we're done. Our next meal is salmon with vegetables. Again, are great standby frozen vegetables. You can keep them in your freezer for months. You don't have to go to the store all the time. These are your friend. Okay, we're gonna take 2 1/3 cups of vegetables, pop those in the microwave. Okay, vegetables are done. That took almost 3 minutes because there were so many of them. Now we're going to add half a can of boneless, skinless salmon.
Look! My dog eats better than that.
Well, Hans, this is a great time to remind you of what I said in the first video. And that is that a big part of the obesity problem in America is that foods taste too good. Who can say no to a bag of mega nacho cheesy poofs? You just eat till they're gone. These meals are intentionally pretty basic and boring, so you won't be inclined to overeat. Besides, I can't make anything better. And again, you get your choice of delightful toppings. If your doctor says okay, you can put salt on. My favorite is salsa, just vegetables, no sugar, no fat. And also nice for a change is balsamic vinegar. A lot of flavor, no fat, no sugar. Now here's a really quick and easy one that I like. It's bean salad. It's got tons of fiber, really fills you up, and I personally think it's tasty. Of course, the foundation of every meal, vegetables. So we're going to get that started. 2/3 of a cup of vegetables. kidney beans. They're great. No fat and tons of fiber. They really fill you up. So we're going to use a cup of these in our bean salad. Okay, I'm going to drain the juice. And when our vegetables are done, we're going to add a cup of the kidney beans. And again, our choice of two delightful flavorings. Salt if your doctor says it's okay, but I like balsamic vinegar. And you have a very tasty, filling meal with lots of protein and lots of fiber. This meal is cheating a bit. We're going to use a TV dinner. But as always, we're going to start out with our frozen mixed vegetables. We're going to get those started, 2/3 of a cup. Now, there's a lot more choices in TV dinners than there used to be. There's many kinds in the store that are actually healthy. You just need to read the labels carefully. So what you need to look for is one that has lots of vegetables and very little fat. And we want less than 10% of the calories from fat. So we're going to take this one. And there we go. Now let's look at an emergency meal. Sometimes you're places where there's no refrigerator and there's no microwave. So what do? You don't want to get a candy bar out of the vending machine or a burger from a fast food place. So what can you do when you don't have the time or facilities to make a good meal? Let me show you. You're going to be sorry you ask. Okay, oats. We're going to take half a cup of dry oats. And we're going to put it in a Tupperware container. We're going to take some dairy whey, some protein powder. This is 25 grams protein. And we're going to seal it up. This is completely sealed. It's dry ingredients. This would keep for weeks or months. You can keep it in your backpack, in your car. And then when you're hungry and it's mealtime and you can't eat anything, all you gotta do is put some water in it, stir it up, and it's actually a lot better than it sounds. And it certainly beats a candy bar. The oats in the Tupperware was one solution when you don't have a refrigerator and microwave. Well, let me show you another. Canned chili. Now, consider this a great opportunity to gross out your friends. Canned chili tastes pretty darn good right out of the can, and you don't need to heat it up. It's got lots of protein, lots of fiber. I would suggest getting a turkey chili, low fat, make sure it's low fat. And for an instant meal, it's pretty healthy. Canned chili. But remember, it spoils really quick after you open the can, so if you don't eat the whole can, chuck it. This meal is a treat. It's a little higher in calories than the rest, but it's great. Protein shake, homemade. What we're gonna do, we're gonna take a cup of orange juice. And 25 grams of dairy whey. And a frozen banana. It's important that the banana be frozen. Otherwise, your shake won't nearly be as creamy. There we go. Let's wrap up by talking about beverages. It's very important that you drink a lot of water. The more the better. I fill this cup probably 3-4 times before noon and drink it. Now, let's talk about what you can't drink. Okay, it's easy. You can't drink anything with calories. No sodas, no fruit juices. I know fruit juices are natural, but they are loaded with calories. It's natural sugar, but it's sugar nonetheless, so no OJ. Now, a lot of people just can't do without their colas or their carbonated beverages. Now, let me show you what I do when I absolutely have to have one. I just take normal seltzer water. All this is water with carbon dioxide bubbles mixed in. So what I do is I take... Whoa. I can't keep anything nice. I put the carbonated water in. And then what I use for flavor is just a single drop of lime or lemon oil. And it's amazing. It gives it amazing flavor. You have a great, refreshing beverage with no calories. Okay, that wraps it up. In these two videos, I've shown you how to lose weight and get six-pack abs through exercise and nutrition. It's not difficult or expensive, but it does take some time and dedication. Don't start tomorrow, start today. Go for a brisk 30-minute walk right now. You'll be amazed how much better you feel after just your first walk. Good luck.